Our worst fears have come to pass. The One Ring has revealed itself. And as the Fellowship prepares for its perilous journey to Mount Doom, the shadow of Sauron stretches forth to reclaim it. In ages long past, the Witch King gathered a dark army in Angmar. Once again, he calls a vast horde from the depths of Khandoum to march upon the lands of Middle-earth and lay them to rest. Aragorn and I hoped the Rangers alone could hold back the Witch King's advance, and that Angmar's strength had not yet grown too great. We were wrong. Unite the free peoples of Eriador and inspire them to stand against Sauron. For if you do not oppose the army of Angmar, then all the lands of Middle-earth will fall forever into darkness and shadow. War is at hand. The time is now. The age of man is fast approaching. The chosen of a higher power, men dominate the lands of Middle-earth, both west and east of the Misty Mountains. Their strength of will and prowess at arms will decide the fate of Middle-earth, whether for good or for ill. The Warden is a master of the spear and javelin, sworn to protect those that cannot protect themselves. At home, in the thick of melee, the Warden weaves powerful combinations of attacks to fell her foes and strengthen her own resolve against the Dark Lord.
A chance encounter with brigands upon the road leads to captivity. You awaken with the Ranger Strider before you. As he urges you to act quickly, you realize you have become involved in matters much greater than yourself. Enough!
Come along. We are not safe just yet.
Hurry, friend. We must test your will to fight.
Thank you.
Well done. Let us press on. Here is where we must part ways.
How do you do?
Go back to the Shadow Fallen King! Folk. I regret that I was but a moment too late, but all is not lost.
Wounded by a Black Rider, the Ranger Umdir escaped with his charges into the wild, making his way back to the village of Archit.
There, Captain Brackenbrook, a retired sellsword, has allowed Strider and his companions to stay and take respite from their cares.
Thank goodness you're awake. That fellow Omdir seems very ill.
Do not trouble yourself on my account. It is only a chill. There are too many deeds to be done, all pressing, and none of them easy. Perhaps you can help, my friend. Captain Brackenbrook will not heed my warnings.
I don't like the look of those rangers one bit.
What do you need? Greetings.
How can I be of service?
Alas, for peaceful folk everywhere, it is an enormous task to convince them that evil people with evil intentions will commit evil deeds. Before you try to fight, you must learn what skills you may from the trainer.
Might I take a moment of your time? How can I be of service? Greetings.
Do
Do you feel confident in what you have learned? Undyr, my poor old friend. A shadow has crept over him.
I don't like the look of those rangers one bit. Well, well, if it isn't the rumor monger.
Impossible! A weakling like you defeated the Wolfmaster?
Calder Cobb is a traitor. Danger has found you earlier than I predicted. I cannot decide which is more dangerous right now. Calder Cobb's treachery, or the ignorance of Captain Brackenbrook.
What can I do for you?
How can you say this? Calder Cobb has been loyal to me since he was a boy.
I suppose it would be wise to investigate your claim.
Deer looks so changed since last night.
Hey, you there! I'm hungry!
Thank you. A stranger, eh? You're the best thing that's happened to us all day. Our best hope is to get help from Combe, our neighbors. They will not let our Chet fall to brigands.
Would you do something for me? What do you need?
This cannot be. I must write to Brackenbrook at once.
This will do nicely. It gives me something to munch on for a bit, at least.
Lovely. This is sure to cheer on dear right up. This tea will help Omdir feel better. I just know it.
I thank you, but I have not the stomach to drink this now.
Did my tea perk him up? I knew it would!
What have I done?
You cannot fathom just how wrong I have been.
Do not despair. You have done well.
Thank you.
I presume you're here to bring me ill news from town. Calder Cobb has shown his true colors at last.
Thank you.
What do you need?
could work, my friend. I believe there is hope for us yet. We only need a strategy.
Listen to my words. I am Galadriel, the Lady of the Golden Wood. Do not be afraid, my friend. Your people are short-lived, but the fate of Middle-earth is yours to command. I will not long disturb your sleep. I can visit you in dreams for only a short time. I have looked into my mirror and seen much that worries me. Let me show you.
Thank you.
You are near to wakefulness. The last tendrils of sleep will soon release you. You ask why I wanted to show you this? It is for one reason. I saw you in my mirror, not once or twice, but often. Whether you desire it or not, your fate is tied to that of Middle-earth. Do not forget my words when you awaken. The free peoples of Middle-earth will have need of you. You must not fail.
At your service, and your families.
A dead end will surely work in our favor.
John Brackenbrook and his hunters have reached the outskirts of Archit to find it already ablaze. A desperate struggle to save their village is about to begin. Hopefully, you have arrived in time.
We have no time to lose. We must save Ned! Chet must still be saved. There are more up ahead. Find my father before it's too late. Look, Atli is ahead. All must not be lost. Well met, friend. Is the crafting hall safe? Although the mad badger burns, I still hold out hope. Father, I knew you would survive.
Ranger. Father! No!
Misery has befallen us. My father was right to trust no one.